Hello, welcome to my daily guide with Mdgolamide, and happy midweek to you all. Bread of life, we have come to dine with you this day. Please feed us to the overflowing in the name of Jesus. Amen. And still on the book of Judges, we are taking Judges series 6 with the topic The Unfaithfulness of Man, part 6, under the caption Truth, part 4. And so far so good, we have talked about 3 judges the Lord used to deliver the Israelites after Joshua's death. And after the death of each of these judges, the Israelites go back to their vomit. And every time they go back to their sinful ways, they have a consequence to bear, which is that they would be delivered into the hands of their enemies. So this time around, after the death of Ehud, it was Jabin, the king of Canaan, that tormented them for 20 years. He was a mighty king with 900 chariots of iron. Again, they cried unto this merciful God in spite of their own unfaithfulness. And the Lord answered them. And once again, he raised a 4th judge and a prophet, for that matter, by name Deborah, the wife of Lappidoth. The scripture records in chapter 4 verse 5 that she dwells under the palm tree which had even been named after her, the palm tree of Deborah, between Ramah and Bethel in Mount Ephraim. And the children of Israel came up to her for judgment. So for people to seek out Deborah's judgment, it shows her court ruling was fair enough. So just as the king of Canaan called Jabin as a captain by name Caesarea, Deborah, by the Lord's leading, chose Barak as the commander. He was instructed to select 10,000 men of war from the house of Naphtali and Zebulun. Even when Barak's faith couldn't accept that which was assigned to him by the Lord, she, Deborah, was courageous enough to say, "Okay, I will surely go with thee." That's in verse 9 of that chapter 4. However, the Lord will deliver Caesarea, the captain of Canaanite's army, into the hand of a woman. And so, you see what the spirit of fear and doubting can cause. Barak was robbed of that glory because of fear and doubt. No wonder James chapter 1 verse 8 says, "A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways." That is, a man that is doubting is not stable in all his ways. He will be robbed of some blessings. We continue on lessons learned from character Deborah next week by His grace. So, Thursday, Friday, we'll be looking at our questions and answers and contributions. It's going to be sessions of questions, answer, and contributions so that we can cover up some of the backlog questions we already have. So let's take our closing prayer for today. Father, according to your word, I resist every spirit of fear, doubt, and unbelief so they don't hinder my prayers or block my blessings from you, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Prayer point 2. Right now, Lord, I take authority over every satanic attack that has placed me, my family, or even my nation, Nigeria, under siege. And I declare in the name that is above every other name, such siege is over.